What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrey, and today I'm gonna be doing an update on SNDL stock. First of all, brief information about this company. SNDL Growers engaged in the production and distribution of flower, pre-rolls and vapes. It operates through the following segments: cannabis, ornamental flowers and corporate. The cannabis segment includes legal cultivation and distribution of cannabis products under federally regulated licenses issued by Health Canada. We are on their website. As you can see from my previous video, it was published on March the 1st. We have this news that SNDL to announce full year and fourth quarter 2020 financial results on March 17th. And on top of that, following the release of its full year and fourth quarter financial results, SNDL will host a conference call and webcast at 10:30 a.m. Eastern Time on March 18, 2021. And they will have a press conference, as you can see, and they will tell all the information that they might tell to shareholders and to investors of their company. And here we can see some forecasts. We are on fxstreet.com, and this article was published on March the 4th. And the SNDL forecast that was written there is SNDL will release Q4 earnings on March 17, 2021. SNDL results for Q3 2020 showed an earnings per share loss of $0.09, which was 71 cents higher than Q3 2019, and ahead of estimates for an $0.11 loss. Revenue was $9.85 million. Expectations had been for revenue of $16.89 million. Recent capital rises, while boosting SNDL's cash position, have been dilutive. On December 21, 2020, SNDL said it had 840 million shares outstanding, and by February 4, 2021, it said it had 1.56 billion shares outstanding. Basically, it's not a good sign for now because they diluted their shares, but all will depend on the money that they have for now and how they will spend this money. We are on an article that was published on March the 5th. SNDL stock news. SNDL Growers Incorporated is in free fall as Reddit momentum slows. And they have three key bullets. NASDAQ SNDL drops 10.77% as global markets officially hit a major correction. Second bullet, SNDL remains attractive to investors for its debt-free operations and Canadian market share. And the third bullet is Canadian cannabis industry preparing for a shake-up for a new mega merger. And I mentioned about this merger in some of my previous video, and it is the merger between Tilray and Aphria. It says this merger will create the largest cannabis company in Canada. SNDL has an estimated 3% market share of Canada's industry, but a lot of that might be eaten by the new mega company. With its cash position, SNDL has already acquired a couple of smaller players and may look to acquisitions as a way to inorganically expand operations. So, everything will depend on their report and on their press conference, where they should announce some new paths for the company and what will they do with the money that they have. And they just made one investment. It was an Indiva, and it is the company that will give an opportunity for SNDL to expand their market on eatable products. As you can see, all this news, they lead us to this information, and we are on Fintel.io. It is institutional investors in this company, and as you can see, we have recent sell by this company, Auxier Asset Management, and they closed their position, and let me show you the amount of shares that they just sell. As you can see, they sold just $29,000 in value, and it's not a big stake of the company. And as you can see, we have more and more red lines, and this leads us to this forecast. We are on Vanguard.com, and here is SNDL Growers, and their forecast is to hold position. Three analysts make this forecast, and we have two analysts that encourage us to sell this asset. And this is the all information that I want to provide from the fundamental standpoint. And before we dive deep into the technical analysis, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done this before. Hit the notification bell in this case you won't miss my next video, and hit the like button if you like my video. On my previous video, I encourage you to enter this trade if you are ready to have this risky trade. I warn you that it was quite risky, and we've hit our stop loss of 17.78%, and it is all about bear market. We have two consecutive weeks of red days, and that's why all the penny stocks they are dumping so hard. And that's why all the trades, all the long positions, they are quite risky. I mean, all the long positions that are for swing trades and for maybe scalping, they are very, very risky. And the only way you can handle that is the experience. You have to be a very experienced trader to handle these positions. And we don't need this anymore. And as you can see, we broke this resistance. It was my previous entry point in my first video. And from this entry point, your position might be up of more than 300%. And I didn't make any updates while this huge spike occurred. I missed it, and that's why I don't count on this level as your entry price. So for now, we break this resistance and bounce back. And on daily time frame, as you can see, it is still a resistance, because this week tells us that bears try to push the asset down, and for now bulls regain the control. They push it up, and this candle close above the resistance. And as you can see, the yellow line, it is a exponential moving average 55, and it is also very, very strong support. And as you can see, here is our long-term support. It is a confluent zone between two zones of support, and basically I think it is a good sign for this asset. And on top of that, this very candle, it is a hammer, and it is a bullish candle, and the higher this volume is, the more bullishness it has. So for now, it's not so bullish because the volume is rather low, and this means during all the red days we might go even lower. But we have the second hammer, as you can see, in a row, and this candle might be a trend reversal. But for now, it is very difficult to say, because we will expect a good news from this earnings report. And let me show you one more thing. Here is for our time frame, and I will switch to log scale, and this trend line I draw on my previous video. And as you can see, we respect this trend line, and for now it is in my opinion also a good sign that we might hold this position. And if you like this company, if you want to invest in this company, you just accumulate your position each and every red day, and in a matter of months, in my opinion, you will be profitable anyway, because in my previous video I mentioned that this market is expanding, and more and more countries and more states legalizing cannabis right now. It is a good sign for all of the companies, and for now we have a great management in Sundial Growers, and they have a plenty of money, and in my opinion this company will be successful. Just buy and hold, and you will be profitable. With that being said, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done this before, and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. See you guys next time. Bye.